Good afternoon, everyone. This is Rajnikanth from RK University, Rajkot. I had presented a paper on University Bridge Program, so which is one of the innovations at the grassroots of learning in higher education at RKU. I am actually the coordinator of this program, and I had successfully implemented this for the past 2 years, and I had published and presented the paper in the early January at Pune. So coming to the today's agenda, the major, you know, majorly speaking about what is actually the need of UBP, then I'll be coming up with the introduction and the proposed model of UBP at RKU, and for implementing our UBP, whatever the training we have done at here, and then I'll be discussing the implementation and finally the result improvement which we had achieved. So basically speaking about the problem statement, so speaking at the universities and colleges of higher education, what we observed is, you know, students who are actually taking admission in universities, they are actually not sufficiently prepared, you know, to have their classwork or to have their coursework at universities. Generally, when we see the results of the students at universities, they are actually very low when compared to the results, the scores they are actually getting in the 12th standard. This is because there is actually a gap between the 12th standard as well as the university level. And when we look at universities, we are actually getting students from various geographical locations, from various boards of study. Some will be coming from the state board, some will be coming from the CBSE, and even students are coming from various economical backgrounds, and their medium of study is also going to differ. And all these students, when actually coming into a university, the faculties who are actually delivering the classwork to these particular students, they are actually experiencing the heterogeneous student groups. And these heterogeneous student groups, some will be proficient with the prerequisite skills required for the current course of study, and few are actually not good at the prerequisite required for the course of study. And the faculty who is actually delivering the course, who is actually delivering the particular subject, he will be confused to handle that particular heterogeneous student groups. This problem is existing everywhere in the country, and we at RKU had taken it very seriously, and then we started looking at the problem from our university perspective as well. Then when we started looking at RKU, on one front, our major objective is to make the students give the necessary domain knowledge to successfully grasp the concepts beyond their previous grade level. So whatever actually the subjects we are giving, whatever actually the courses we are delivering at RKU, we want 100% audibility. Every student has to grasp, every student has to understand, every student should be able to apply what actually is being taught at RKU. And coming to the other front, at RKU, we actually, you know, are very much focused, and we are doing a lot of teaching and learning innovations, and here active learning approach. So all the courses, all the subjects at RKU are delivered by using this active learning approach. Now the students who are actually coming to RKU, they already had a decade of education where they are very much habituated with the passive learning mode, and now when they have taken in admission at RKU, one thing is we found they are actually not having the required prerequisite skills, which are actually required to understand, you know, the domain courses which are delivered. The other one is they are actually very passive in mode. They are not ready for the active learning where they have to actively involve in the discussions with the faculty. So we, after analyzing the complete problem, being a new age university, we decided to come out of this particular problem, and As I already mentioned, coming to the teaching and learning environment at RKU, we actually emphasize and we believe that our students should be able to follow the self-learning, they should be able to have the do the group work, and they should be able to work in a team, and you know, active participation is required. And as already I mentioned, you know, all the classes are actually activity-based classes over here. Students are divided into various groups, activities are given, pre-readings are given, and students has to come up with the pre-readings, and actual discussion happens in the classwork at in RKU. So now we have to make all the students, you know, ready for this, you know, new kind of learning where, you know, students are able to apply what actually they have learned, and this is what actually, you know, we are looking at RKU, and this is what actually, you know, going to be a success at RKU. As I mentioned, the basic, again, the problem is students are habituated with the passive learning modes. So now, to overcome all this, you know, we started with a course known as UBP, which stands for University Bridge Program, and this particular UBP program helps us in making the students understand, learn the prerequisite skills, and making all the heterogeneous student groups stand at the same level. And this particular UBP program is delivered by using the active learning methods, that is, you know, by including various activities. So what we decided is, every year, every academic year, when a fresh student takes admission into RKU, he or she has to undergo 3 to 4 weeks of the University Bridge Program. And speaking at RKU, we have various schools where, you know, students studying engineering, students studying physiotherapy, pharmacy, MBA, MCA, BSc, MSc, all these students are actually going to take admission at RKU. So looking at the perspective of the students who are taking admission into RKU, we had divided, you know, UBP into two modes. One is, we are going to have common set of courses which are offered to all the students across all the courses of university, and we also have one or two specific domain knowledge courses for the particular specific school. If I speak about MSc people, they will be having their own domain subject along with the 5 common subjects which actually we are delivering. Like that, engineering people have their own domain courses. Physiotherapy people have their own domain courses. Now, coming to the common areas, we have identified the common areas from the graduate attributes which are actually specified by the NBA. So here we have the list of graduate attributes. Sorry. So after having a detailed study of the various graduate attributes, we had identified the courses to be delivered, and even, you know, before you know, showing the list of the courses, coming to the major objectives of the UBP, what actually we want to, you know, achieve from this. So we want the students to be ready for the new learning environment at the university, and as I already mentioned, we want to the students to be encouraged for the self-learning. We want to bridge the knowledge gaps in the core areas, that is getting the prerequisite knowledge. And we want to bridge the communication skills gap as well, which is, you know, very much required as and now in the corporate world. The next is, you know, we want to promote the group learning and the teamwork, and we want to make the students at RKU familiar with the active learning, so that, you know, they are going to actively involve in the various courses in the next 3 to 4 years of the course of study. Then coming to the courses offered under UBP, so the common courses include, you know, course like life skills, where we are focusing on teaching them the creative thinking, critical thinking, and emotional control. So these life skills helps the students in overcoming the stress, and it really helps them, you know, when they are actually trying to come up with some innovative ideas and how to take the right decisions, the life skills actually is going to help them. Then we have a course with the name soft skills. As the name itself says, it helps the students in, you know, getting the required, the basic communication skills, the relationship skills, the business skills, etc. Then we have the another course known as personality development course, and this course really speaks about making the students, you know, as the positive thinkers, you know, thinking from the positive point of view, and even, you know, this helps in the ethical thinking as well. Then we have another course known as Information Literacy for 21st Century, where we will be discussing the basic computer knowledge required by every university students, like MS Office, MS Word, Google Apps. All these were actually, you know, discussed over here, and even we are going to discuss the LMS, the Learning Management System used at university, as well as we are also going to discuss the ERP, which is actually being used at the university. Then we have another program, which is S Plus Happiness, which is actually a modified program for our university from the Art of Living. And this course helps the students in understanding, you know, on meditation and stress relief, and all the students, you know, will be practicing Sudarshan Kriya, etc. And these are actually the common courses which all the students at the RKU are going to undergo. Then we have, as I mentioned, school-specific courses. If I speak about engineering, we have a refresher course on physics and mathematics, where we are going to refresh the fundamentals of physics and the mathematics, which they have learned in the 12th standard, and that helps in the filling of the gap for the mathematics and the physics that they are going to learn in engineering as well. Then we have subjects like Introduction to Engineering, where for every student, every engineering student, you know, we are going to have the fundamentals of all the branches of engineering. Even if a computer science student is going to undergo the fundamentals of electrical engineering, fundamentals of civil engineering, fundamentals of mechanical engineering as well. So this makes the students understand the scopes of various branches of engineering, and this also helps them in thinking about the interdisciplinary innovations. So that is what actually the basic idea of introducing this course. Then if I speak about my B Pharmacy student, they will be having a course Introduction to Pharmacy, where the prerequisite, you know, pharmaceutical concepts will be delivered for them. Then similarly, we have a course known as Professional Orientation for Physiotherapy, and this is actually again a prerequisite fundamental domain course for the physiotherapy students. So this is the way, you know, we have identified various courses, and all these courses are offered under UBP at RKU. So now, as I mentioned, students are habituated to the passive learning mode. At the same time, our teaching faculty are also habituated with the passive teaching. So that is, you know, a faculty gets into a classroom and starts delivering a class for all the 15 minutes or the 1 hour of the time, where even faculty never expects, you know, an interaction from the student. So now, what we planned at RKU is, at first, our faculty are required to be trained on active learning techniques and strategies. So coming to this active learning, what exactly happens? So here in the active learning classroom, the class will be, you know, moved from the instructor mode to the student mode, back to the instructor mode. So this is the way actually an active learning class is going to be. And this active learning helps the students, you know, in developing their cognitive skills, their thinking skills. So, but to learn, to make the students, faculty trained on the active learning skills, here at RKU, we have with us Mr. Mohit Patel. He is the Vice President of RKU University, and he has done his MS in Education from Harvard University, and he is very much passionate towards the teaching and learning strategies, and he had developed a course known as Learning Experience Design, and this course is of a stretch of 20 hours course, and all the faculties of RKU will be undergoing this particular learning experience design. So in this particular course, Mr. Mohit Patel will be training the faculty on various active learning strategies, on preparing the lesson plans which really suits to this particular active learning strategies. So the faculties at RKU are actually trained on these skills by Mr. Mohit Patel, And the faculties are going to develop or prepare the micro lesson plans. It is not going to be like a normal lesson plan. I know it is going to be a micro lesson plan where the faculty is going to clearly mention how he is going to deliver the session of that particular 50 minutes or 1 hour. He is going to have a clear time division. He is going to mention the activity he is going to perform. He is also going to have the session objectives. He is also going to provide what kind of assessment he is going to do to understand the learning that has been taken, by the student. So now we have conducted such LUD training programs over here, and almost all the faculties at RKU are, LUD trained. And now these trained faculties were actually mapped with the particular UBP courses, and the faculties were actually asked to prepare the lesson plans. Here I will showcase one lesson plan. Here I had one lesson plan, you can understand. So this is a session for 60 minutes, and it had a clear division that it says the topic of the course, it is a critical thinking which comes under logical and reasoning skills. And the course is conducted by Dr. Chetana Parmar, and date of conduction, it is in the, when actually the course is going to take place. And here we have, we can see the session lesson objectives. We are able to see the learning outcomes. We are going to have the background information for the particular session as well. And then the resources required for the particular class. And here we have the activity to be performed during the class by the various students. So like this, for every session of the particular course, we are going to have a micro lesson plan. And here, when we speak about our micro lesson plans, we say that lesson plans are not for the faculty, but for the other faculty. In a particular emergency situation, if a faculty who is supposed to take a session is on leave or absent, the other faculty can go for delivering the same session, and where the complete lesson plan, the complete session plan, the delivery is going to remain same. Here, when we started, implementing UBP, we also identified, achieving uniformity in the course delivery is very much important. So the lesson plans really helped us in achieving that particular uniformity in implementing this UBP across the university. So coming to the UBP implementation, as we know, when the first year students comes in, already we have the higher semester classes going on, and being a university program, so mapping of the faculties to their respective modules with respect to their expertization, actually, it has become a very tough task for us. And with all the UBP team available at our university, we are successful in achieving that. And, we are able to plan the timetable such that, there is no disturbance for the higher semesters with respect to, implementing the UBP over here. And, I can say, yes, the implementation is an operational masterpiece, implementing across, 2,500 students across university. So here I have a photograph, my photograph showcases, that how students are, involved in, various activities. When the faculty had given an activity, they are actively involved in performing the particular activity. And here at the another one, as I mentioned, students are involved in various activities, they are again, performing another activity over here. And, here I had my result analysis. We, at the end of the course, we started taking the feedback. And the feedbacks are so positive, and the feedback shows us the students have really enjoyed. And at the end of the course, students are habituated with the active learning modes, and they are happy in participating in the classroom discussion. And after UBP, we also identified the students are actually actively participating in the classroom discussion, and the pain, the problems that actually the faculties are facing initially, that we are actually able to overcome. So here, you know, we taken feedback with respect to the course content and organization, where, you know, 90% of the students, 95% of the students have given either strongly agree or agree with respect to the content we have delivered, with respect to the organization of the particular UBP course. And when you look at the student attendance also, we can see, you know, more number of students, you know, are having 80%+ of attendance with respect to attending the UBP coursework at the university. Then coming to the student contribution, as I mentioned, you know, actively participating in the discussion, they have themselves mentioned that, you know, more than again 95% of the students had, you know, contributed, have actively participated in the classroom discussions. Then actually, as it is a polar opposite, you know, teaching model, we also had taken a feedback on the learning environment and teaching methods, and almost, you know, again, more than 95% of the students said they are very much happy with the teaching methods, the activities chosen by the faculties, and the learning environment that is actually created by the faculties at RKU. And, you know, with respect to this particular feedback, you know, we again, you know, reformed our UBP program, and we have made the required modifications, and we have again successfully implemented UBP for the year 2015-16 as well. And now, you know, we are actually, you know, from the last 1 month, we are doing a lot of brainstorming by looking at our feedbacks and, you know, what modifications are required, what additional changes are required for the UBP, you know, for the students who are actually going to, you know, take admission for the, you know, 2016-17 batch. And no doubt, you know, by looking at the feedbacks, by looking at the result analysis, you know, we at, you know, RKU says that, you know, students who are admitting at RKU University are actually getting a rich, you know, exposure about the latest teaching models, and they are able to fill their prerequisite gaps because of, you know, the learning gap with respect to their previous course of study. And as, you know, as we are implementing it only from the last 2 years, we are expecting, you know, we are going to experience the best outcome of this UBP with respect to their student placements, and even with respect to their, you know, final scores at the end of their graduation degree. And coming to my conclusion, as I said, now this is one of the many systematic grassroots innovations that RKU is, you know, spearheading over here. Actually, you know, we have a project with the name Project North Star, which is actually, again, you know, a model and which is implemented by our Vice President, Mr. Mohit Patel, and UBP is one of such innovations at RKU University. And as I said, you know, now our faculties are, you know, experiencing participatory classes after the UBP. And as I said, you know, we are making the necessary modifications for the UBP course structure as well. And we are ready to take the challenge based upon the UBP feedback. And yes, the last year UBP, even, you know, we have done assessment as well. We have taken an assessment, and based upon the assessment, and, you know, we understood, yes, you know, a good amount of learning had taken place. And yes, I strongly recommend the UBP can be implemented in various higher education institutions in India, wherever they are experiencing the heterogeneous student groups. So this is all from my side, and I'm ready for the questions, if any, from the audience. Hello.
One of them is asking, is the program available in other universities also, like Osmania in Hyderabad or Kakatiya University?
Sir, actually, this is our university course where we have developed for our university and we have implemented for our university. Yes, I say that when speaking about Usmania and Kakatiya University, you know, being a university, they can, you know, plan such program and can implement for their students. And as I mentioned, you know, really it is very much useful in filling the prerequisite gaps. Any more questions, sir? From
We'll give them
participants?
Yes, we'll give them 1 or 2 minutes in case they have more. What is the duration of this program?
As I mentioned, the duration of the program is 3 weeks to 4 weeks. As I mentioned, here at engineering, you know, we are taking it for 4 weeks, but for MBA and MCA, you know, the duration is only 3 weeks. So as I said, it is very much dynamic. We can plan for our students as per the understanding of, you know, the student quality, student heterogeneous at the respective university. And we are offering it as an audit course.
Yes, yes.
So we are offering it as an audit course at RKU. So we are not giving any credits for the course.
Can a student cover in his or her summer vacation?
Yeah. No, sir. Actually, this is implemented in the very first year of their admission to the university. We're not going to implement it every year. So once they have taken admission at RK University in the very first year, we are going to have this particular course. And we are not going to take in the summer vacation, but once the admission has been taken, and you know, on the first day, you know, we are going to start this particular course.
Is a follow-up also envisaged for students going into second or third year?
Yes, actually, means here, you know, as I mentioned, the major objectives are fulfilling the prerequisites and making the students familiar with the active learning strategies. Once the UBP is done in the very first year, you know, as they are, you know, familiar with the active learning techniques and prerequisite skills are done, you know, they will easily, you know, move from the first year to the second year and to the third year. So no issues will come in between. Because all the students are from the same university and you know, the learning happens at the same pace for all of them. But whereas when they are taking admission into university, they are from various boards, as I said, from various geographical locations. You know, learning of a student differs you know, from the college to college, geographical location to location, the board of studies. You know, everyone will have a different set of syllabus, different set of learning, different set of knowledge. And they have to study the common course at university.
Oh, one of the participants says, I think that is equally important to train the faculty. You mentioned the learning design experience. Where can the faculty get such experience in Indian institutes?
Repeat again, sir.
I think it is equally important to train the faculty. You mentioned the learning design experience. Where can faculty get such experience in Indian institutes?
Sir, coming to this, yes, this is you know something challenging, and every Indian institution you know will not be having you know the way we have you know we are very lucky to have Mr. Mohit with us. But actually, you know, where there are you know various IITs you know who are actually training the faculties on this active learning you know strategies. And in fact, even I know they can also refer the various websites. They can have an understanding of you know the various active learning models, and you know this actually even the I can say the college management has to take in the training the faculties, because active learning is actually going to be, you know, implemented, you know, in coming days very actively. And yes, if required, you know, I need to take the permission of the management of RKU. But yes, if RKU management could help, you know, if any request comes from the other institutions. I hope I have answered the question. Hello?
Oh, yes, sir. Just seeing if there are.
Hello?
Just yeah. Checking, sir. Yes, sir, that madam is saying yes, it would be good to collaborate with RKU in this aspect, and to thank you.
Yeah, sure. I hope my paper is available in the, you know, JIT journal, and people can refer it. And, you know, for any help and, you know, for any, you know, further understanding of the program, I always will be there, you know, helping them.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Van.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Thank you.